Good day, everyone. Good to be back again. I hope everybody's getting up for the week. Like what happened yesterday, you know, it's just normal. It's normal for market to retrace after a long move. You know, we saw a lot of red in the market yesterday. I saw a lot of people that are panicking. I was just laughing. You know, and February has always been like this for some time. Even last year, we experienced the same sharp drop around this month. Well, the market seems to be recovering, at least. So, but let's quickly look at the chart and so that we can see what is happening. Really, if you look at the chart, you would notice that Bitcoin was able to hold the support as around for the 3,000. It touches for the 3,000 before we see a bounce. And then we're going to battle with resistance around this axis, around this 46,000, 45,000 axis. Use a resultant line to. So we should see. I feel the first resistance we are going to be battling with will be around there, around that $47,000 axis, $7,000 axis. If that place is broken, move up here, 48,500. That is broken, probably 58,000. Oh, sorry, probably 50, around that 50,000 axis. But then, the market seems to look to, you know, be taking a bearish form. If you look at the weekly chart, the way we closed yesterday, you know, look at the last candle that closed for February. It's a huge bearish candle. But then if you pay attention to this moving average, the one I put on the chart, the 50-day moving average, you will actually notice that for some couple of months, after we have a breakout around this axis where my cursor is, you will notice that price keeps bouncing off on this moving average. Every time it comes in and touches, kisses it, or almost there, it bounce off. So if this support holds, you know, the support we have here on this weekly chart, if it holds around that for the 3,000, where it bounce off, might see Bitcoin move up a little bit more. Probably, well, around this, probably move a little bit more to go and test the upper trend. It's very, very possible. Nothing is possible in trading, especially in crypto space. So if that place holds, you know, we'll see Bitcoin move up a little bit. And you can also notice that there's a lot of volume. Although it's a bearish volume. There's a lot of volume in the market. As you can see, you know, it's as of yesterday and today. So, but the market is still, you know, it's still ranging right now. Going into March, which is the new month we are in right now. Some news, we are expecting some news to come out that might propel, especially the news that came out 2 days ago about the stimulus check that was $1.9 trillion that was signed by President Biden. Normally, I think last year the same thing happened. Anytime that check is signed, we first of all see a sell-off. But after some couple of weeks, you see the market recovering. If that's a scenario, you know, if that speculation plays out, you see Bitcoin move up a little bit more. If it turns out to be positive, I'm talking about the stimulus check that was just signed by the President of the United States. If it holds, you know, we see Bitcoin, you know, do well and move. And of course, you know, when Bitcoin goes up, every other market, every other coin, you know, also move up. Let's look at, I actually want to take a look at Ethereum. Ethereum has been very, 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 very has not been doing well at all. You know, I think everybody's just waiting for Ethereum to talk about the, to start implementing the 2.0, which I feel is going to be towards the end of the year or next year, before we can see the full implementation of ETA 2.0. So Ethereum also kisses, it actually dropped a lot yesterday to 1,293. before it goes back to 1,004, and it seems to be recovering too, just like Bitcoin. As you can see on the 1 hour chart, you don't have a lot of volume. There's no, you know, there's no no volume. People are not excited. You know, there's no volume. There's no volume. So for Ethereum, Ethereum is in a serious bearish mode because it's almost doing 50% retracement from 2042. And I mean, it dropped to as low as 1,200. You know, it's almost going to 1,000. So if this support does not hold, the way I'm looking at Ethereum, we might curve further down to this support, this 1,062, this 1,200 support does not hold. Might see Ethereum kiss 1,046, roughly almost 1,000, or probably come to around 900, you know. So, but then if this support holds, you know, anything can happen in this market, like I always say. Ethereum can move up a little bit to probably around that 1,500. If you go to the weekly chart, you see this the moving average that Bitcoin has been bouncing off from, and Ethereum has also been bouncing off from it since where was this? That was let me look at the date. That was since last year, since November last year towards December last year. Ethereum has been bouncing off this moving average. And finally, yesterday, the candle closed for the month inside this moving average, this is not good. This is not good at all. It's not good at all. The first thing you will see in the coming weeks is Ethereum will test this moving average again. So this moving average has been acting as support, now acts as a resistance. So what you're going to see is we are going to see the testing of this moving average at 1,550 thereabout. You know, if that moving average will not act as a resistance zone, it's going to rather act as a resistance zone. If that price is not broken, we'll see Ethereum dropping sharply, probably below where it's the last low that it did. So for me, Ethereum is not doing good at all, you know, except I don't know, probably something dramatic happened. Like I said, the thing that I feel will, you know, the news, the fundamental news that if you can drive this market is the signing of the stimulus bill that was signed by the President of the United States. You know, it could be a lot of, you know, booster for the market. You could see in the coming weeks, because last year also when that stimulus was signed, the first thing we noticed was a sharp drop in the crypto market, in the stock market, in all the markets. And then, you know, after some couple of, you know, days and weeks, the market recovered, and then it has been up since then. So if that scenario holds this year, might see a move upwards, a better move upwards. But for Ethereum is not really looking good, if you ask me. Ethereum is not looking good at all because of this breaking into this moving average. From, as you can see, the last couple of months, anytime it backs, you know, it bounces off this moving average, you know, it goes up, it forms a higher high. You know, if you want to look at the price, I want to look at it from the lower region, it forms a higher low. You know, from here it goes up, forms another low the following week, forms another low, a higher low, forms another higher low. And then, so what we have now is, you know, the candlesticks for the month, for the week, closing in to that moving average, which is not very good. So the next couple of, you know, weeks, the first thing price will do, if price goes up, is that Ethereum will go and test this moving average. It's going to be a very strong resistance that it will need to deal with, you know, first. So then let's look at Ethereum. Let's look at Ethereum and, you know, the Ethereum and BTC and see. You know, coming, let me look at from the 1 hour. You know, Ethereum actually broke this all-time high that we, if you remember, sometimes some couple of weeks ago when I made a video after Ethereum broke, I'm coming, I think I'll see it on the daily chart probably. This, there was a region that we are looking at, okay, around this area that was broken. and he went all the way, and then it has come back in. So Ethereum is not really looking good. This resistance used to be a very tough resistance for Ethereum for some couple of, for like 2-3 years. And it got broken, but it didn't really move up too much. And like I've been saying in my other videos, the reason is not far-fetched why we didn't see Ethereum, move the way it ought to move, unlike Bitcoin. When Bitcoin broke the all-time high last year, the all-time high that it did 2018, when it broke it last year, we saw a sharp move from around that 20,000 region to 30,000, 40,000, all the way, But Ethereum has a lot of people are anticipating that Ethereum will launch the Ethereum 2.0. And in order, because of the high gas fees, and that didn't happen. So, and then Binance, on the other hand, was able to, launch their own smart chain that solved the exact problem that Ethereum, has been willing to solve, has been for years, that Ethereum has been battling with Binance, ADA, that's Cardano, Polkadot, a lot of projects, came up with the solution. And because of that singular reason, a lot of money moves in from Ethereum as a coin to all those coins. That's why we did see a lot of sharp movement after Ethereum broke $1,400. So at least for me, I was thinking, in the short term, during that period, I was expecting Ethereum to have moved to as high as probably at least $5,000, but that never happened. So that's my thought. I just said I should share with you. In the link below, you could please make sure you follow, make sure you like, make sure you share and comment. And also, I'll be dropping the link to my one of our courses on tradersabout.com. They have a free video on that website that you can watch. And also, you can also, buy the course, and then you can join our WhatsApp group through that link. So that's my thought on the market. So in the short term for Ethereum, I'm seeing Ethereum very bullish. Sorry, bearish, especially if you look at Ethereum and, USDT. So because of, like I said earlier, if you go back to the ETH USDT, if this moving average, that's acting as resistance, if it's not broken, the price should come and test this place, like I said, around that 1,546. If it's not broken up to the upside, we might see a sharp drop below $1,300, probably, further down. So that's my thoughts on the market. So I'll be dropping some. Just make sure you subscribe and, click the notification bell so that when I post a video, you will see the video. Thank you.